Sheikh, to our next question on WhatsApp, and that is on soya sauce. And the question is soya sauce halal to consume, Sheikh?
I was about to say, when it comes to these things that like a soya sauce and so on.
Please go ahead.
In Sharia, we know that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for us on this planet mostly is halal. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, قُلْ مَنْ حَرَّمَ زِينَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي أَخْرَجَ لِعِبَادِهِ وَالطَّيِّبَاتِ مِنَ الرِّزْقِ قُلْ هِيَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. So things that we consume, things that we eat, things that we wear, in general, they are considered to be mubah. Al-qawa'id al-fiqhiyya, based on the fiqh principle, everything on the planet is halal unless we have evidence to contradict that, which is the opposite of ibadah. Ibadah, everything is haram until we have evidence to prove that. When it comes to what we consume, what we drink, what we, or eat, and what we put on, it falls under the mubahat, which means is allowed. When it comes to a particular element, in the case of soya sauce, then you go back and you refer back to the ingredients of that element. If the ingredients contains anything that is prohibited in the Quran and in the Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then you avoid. But if the ingredients is a general thing, is things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already made it mubah in the Quran and the Sunnah, then definitely it falls under that category. Wallahu a'lam. I just wanted to say that as a general term, but I cannot answer a particular soya sauce, whether this is halal or haram, because that's a heavy responsibility to carry on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah.